Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Welcome to St. George's in Paris, and to this Eucharist. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion. His mercy is over all his works. Trusting in the goodness of God, our Creator, we turn to him in penitence for our sins. Lord, you are faithful in all your words and merciful in all your deeds. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You uphold all who fall and lift up those who are bowed down. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are righteous in all your ways and near to those who call upon you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in life eternal. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us pray. O Lord, we beseech you mercifully to hear the prayers of your people who call upon you, and grant that they may both perceive and know what things they ought to do, and also may have grace and power faithfully to fulfil them. We ask it through your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Ezra. At the evening sacrifice I got up from my fasting with my garments and my mantle torn, and fell on my knees, spread out my hands to the Lord my God, and said, O my God, I am too ashamed and embarrassed to lift my head to you, my God. For our iniquities have risen higher than our heads, and our guilt has mounted up to the heavens. For from the days of our ancestors to this day, we have been deep in guilt. And for our iniquities, we, our kings and our priests, have been handed over to the kings of the lands, to the sword, to captivity, to plundering, and to utter shame, as is now the case. But now, for a brief moment, favour has been shown by the Lord our God, who has left us a remnant and has given us a stake in his holy place, in order that he might brighten our eyes and grant us a little sustenance in our slavery. For we are slaves, yet our God has not forsaken us in our slavery, but has extended to us his steadfast love before the kings of Persia, to give us new life, to set up the house of God, to repair its ruins, and to give us a wall in Judea and Jerusalem. The response to Psalm 13, Blessed be God who lives forever.
Blessed be God who lives forever.
Declare God's praise before the nations, you who are the children of Israel. For if our God has scattered you among them, there too has he shown you his great goodness. Blessed be God who lives forever. Exalt him in the sight of the living, because he is our Lord and God and our Father forever. Though God punishes you for your wickedness, mercy will be shown to you all.
Blessed be God who lives forever.
God will gather you from every nation, from wherever you have been scattered. When you turn to the Lord with all your heart and soul, God will hide his face from you no more.
Blessed be God who lives forever.
See what the Lord has done for you and gives thanks with a loud voice. Praise the Lord of righteousness and exalt the King of the ages.
Blessed be God who lives forever.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
That has the power to save your souls.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
In the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus called the 12 together, and he gave them power and authority over all demons and to cure diseases, and he sent them out to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal. He said to them, Take nothing for your journey, no staff, nor bag, nor bread, nor money, not even an extra tunic. Whatever house you enter, stay there and leave from there. Wherever they do not welcome you, as you are leaving that town, shake the dust off your feet as a testimony against them. They departed and went through the villages, bringing the good news and curing diseases everywhere. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
So in the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. O God, the Creator and Preserver of all, we pray for people in every kind of need. Make your ways known on earth, your saving health among the nations. Especially today, we pray for the United Nations, for the heads of government gathered in New York. We pray for those who are charged with responsibility for the international order, for the maintenance of rules and laws, for the safety of the whole human family. Especially we pray for those preparing for the climate change conference in the UK. Lord, in your mercy,
hear
our
prayer.
We pray for the good estate of the Catholic Church, guide and govern us by your good spirit, that all who profess and call themselves Christians may be led in the way of truth and hold the faith in unity of spirit, in the bond of peace and in righteousness of life. Especially today we pray for the chaplaincy of Mallorca, including Palma de Mallorca, Puerto Palencia, Calador and Palma Nova, for their chaplain Yashanesu Gushu and Bill Boyce, and for their readers Linda Cade and Vicky Pacey. Pray especially for the chaplaincy as it seeks to respond to the challenges of Brexit. We remember too in the Anglican Communion, the community of the Sacred Passion in the UK, the community of St Mary of Nazareth and Calvary in Tanzania and Zambia, and the community of Saints Barnabas and Cecilia in Australia. We pray for an openness to the Spirit in the work of the Church. Lord, in your mercy, we commend to your fatherly goodness all those who are in any ways afflicted or distressed in mind, body or estate. Comfort and relieve them in their need. Give them patience in their sufferings and bring good out of all their afflictions. We give thanks today on International Sign Language Day for all those who work in the chaplaincy to the deaf. We pray for those who teach sign language, for those who seek to, for those who translate the gospel. We remember those on our chaplaincy sick list. Especially today, we pray for Lucas, Margot, Alex, and Max, Sarah, Marussia, Laurence, Marie-Thérèse, Susan, David, Paul, and Saul. Lord, in your mercy, we remember those who have gone before us in the peace of Christ, and we give praise for all your faithful ones with whom we rejoice in the communion of saints. Especially at this time, we pray for Aidan Mayos, priest, member of the Community of the Resurrection, who died this week, and also for Vera Popovitsky and André Durand, whose anniversaries fall at this time. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord.
And let the perpetual shine upon them.
We remember before the Lord our own intentions for this and the coming weeks. All this we ask for Jesus' sake. Merciful Father,
accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ.
Jesus said to the apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you, not as the world gives do I give to you. May the peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our cup of salvation.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, he lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that by the power of your Holy Spirit and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died, Christ is risen, Christ will come again.
And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people, and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. George, St. Genevieve, and of all your saints, may praise and glorify you forever. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. Amen. We pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
And though we are many, we are one body.
Because we all share in one bread, Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us your peace. Behold the Lamb of God who takes away. away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
Body of Christ. Almighty God, you have taught us through your Son that love is the fulfilling of the law. Grant that we may love you with our whole heart and our neighbours as ourselves, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.